what generalized anxiety disorder is. So basically, where most people sort of rest at a neutral state, I rest at anxious. I'm an anxious person. I'm anxious about everything. That's what the generalized anxiety is. Some people with anxiety disorders only have social anxiety, or they only have anxiety. Maybe they're agoraphobic or they're scared of going places. I have general anxiety about like everything. And it's basically like when it's unmanaged and I don't have the appropriate care in my life, it becomes so overwhelming that I can barely function. I can barely do much. When I left Swords to Plowshares and went to that tech job, and went to a big giant tech company on a contract, I was getting paid like double what I was getting paid at the nonprofit, and that was sweet and nice for the 3 months that I was there. But of course I ended up losing that position, being thrown out to the wolves with no other real opportunities at the time. And that just sort of accelerated the generalized anxiety. I started get, you know, and of course, like my plan going into that tech company was actually to start seeing a therapist and to, you know, get into mental health care. But of course, losing that position before my health care kicked in, and then now being, you know, unemployed, no health care, I sort of went the opposite direction. I wasn't able to take care of the issues until a year or so after that, January of 2019, when I got my other job at a different nonprofit, October of 2018. And then 3 months after that, my healthcare kicked in. So that's why right around January of 2019 is when I started finally seeing a therapist. But I had known since maybe 2015 or 16 that I was an anxious person, and that this was sort of, my anxiety was getting in the way of my life and my ability to function. But I was functional up until, I would say, January of 2019. It got so bad that I had to get some professional care. My therapists were actually a huge reason why I ended up reaching out to my biological family and putting those pieces back together, because through about a year of therapy, that was where we sort of determined that, okay, this is something that you really need to do. Mm-hmm. Because again, my anxiety, it had become a barrier, a massive barrier in my life. And generalized anxiety disorder is a very livable disease. Basically, like if you can create your life in such a way that you don't expose yourself to certain triggers, you can live pretty much symptom free. And that's basically how I've been now for the last 6 or 7 months or so. I've changed my lifestyle so drastically to feed into my wellness versus to feed into my anxiety. So lifestyle change, journaling, daily journaling, meditation, mindfulness practice, gratitude, daily affirmations, those sorts of things. Affirmations have been huge for me because I have really anxious thoughts and paranoid thoughts. So mm-hmm. affirming sort of against those negative thoughts and forcing myself to think like, you're calm, you're calm, you're calm.